Now we have our Town Hall Award. Now, just out of curiosity, how many people here over the summer recess, the recess from hell, as Democrats call it, made it to a town hall meeting on health care, just by a show of hands? Now, those of you who actually made it to a town hall meeting, how many of you actually got to speak on the microphone directly to your representative? Wow, like two. Of the two of you, how many of you held up a $20 bill and demanded that your representative come down from the stage and take it out of your hand as a symbolism of the government robbing us of our hard-earned money? I think only one person fits that description, and she's our winner of the Town Hall Award. It recognizes individuals who delivered eloquent and passionate town hall speeches. Our winner tonight challenged Congressman Norm Dicks, a Democrat from Washington, to personally take her $20 bill to pay for government health care, directly illustrating the demands the bill would make on taxpayers. Well known as the Liberty Belle, two L's and an E, she's also been an active Tea Party member from its beginnings in the Seattle area. She's been featured in the New York Times and on National Public Radio, two very friendly news outlets, I might add. Please join me in congratulating Keli Carender.
I don't want to correct you, but it's Keli. Well, I just want to say thank you so much to Sam Adams Alliance for putting this on. I think it really is important to incentivize people to become active in civics and in politics. And as my loving and very supportive fiance said, what better way to incentivize capitalists than to reward them? So I think I guess what I just wanted to make a few remarks kind of about coming out of the conservative closet or the libertarian closet or the right of center closet, whatever closet we live in. Because living in Seattle, obviously it is not the most popular point of view to come from that side or from that closet. And for I don't know how many years, maybe 10 years or so, I do improv theater, so all of my friends are actors and theater people, and I used to sit there and listen to the really horrible things that they would say, like, you know, we're racist and all the things that they're saying now. And I sat there and I took it. And it wasn't until 2008, but I had to start saying something and I had to start fighting back, because they are slandering us, they are maligning us. And our silence vindicates what they're saying. By staying quiet about it, we're saying, yeah, you're right, that is what we are, and we should be ashamed of ourselves. Well, forget that. I am so sick of it. I am so sick of being quiet about it. I'm so sick of somebody making me feel ashamed because I want the government to stay out of my life, or because I want to keep what I've earned, or because I look at my family. My mom grew up in a little adobe house in New Mexico that her father built with his own two hands, and both of my grandparents had no more than a third grade education, and my grandpa blew up tunnels in the mountains of New Mexico and broke his back doing it, to me going to Oxford to getting my graduate degree. And that happened in the span of three generations, and that only happens in America, and I'm not ashamed to say that that's an awesome thing. And I think that what I wanted to do when I went to Norm Dick's Town Hall, he's such a great name, that what I wanted to do was to bring the debate out of the practicalities of the healthcare bill, because by debating the practicalities, we are already giving ground to them, because we're saying, well, then maybe if it was done this other way, it would work. We're already giving into their side of the argument. They win the debate already when we argue only the practicalities. And I wanted to bring the philosophical views home. And I wanted him to be a man about it. And I think that's where we need to go from here is really forcing these people to have these philosophical debates. Because the left, the Marxists, the socialists, the social democrats, whatever name they want to give themselves, the progressives, whatever label they choose that's least offensive to the majority of Americans, they believe in these really cockeyed philosophies, and when you try to pin them down, they can't defend themselves. And we have the philosophy that works, because liberty, individual liberty, always works. And I'll just close with this. When in history did anyone ever fight and die to become a slave? When? Think about it. People fight and die across history and across geography. In every single country, in every single culture, people fight for freedom. And I dare you to ask, if you could go back in time to when America had slaves, if you could ask them, if you could ask a slave, would you rather be free or have someone give you a doctor's appointment? I'm sorry, but freedom takes it every single day. And that is what we are fighting for. And I'm so honored to be among so many awesome people who won this. And thank you so much, Sam Adams Alliance, for doing this. And thank you to my fiance and my family and my parents. And go freedom!
Kelly just stole my speech. I'm going. I'll see you guys later.